something is not adding up. And let not coronavirus change our language as the house of the living God. Let not this virus make us to become new people altogether who don't know their God. This too shall pass. And this devil is not a new devil. This devil may have another name, but it's the same old devil that has been raising up his head all these years. And the word of our God will never change. He says, my word endureth forever. He says, grass shall wither and flowers shall fade, but my word shall endure forever. Let us not forget the word of our God. Therefore, thank you for coming into the house. And those of you who have just joined us live, I appreciate you. And I see some of you are repeat viewers, meaning you love this church. You love this fellowship. You are watching us in the morning. You are still watching us even now. What a love. Give them a hand. Man, I love these great people of God. Thank you for loving church. We are not usually this empty. If you see empty seats, it's because of government regulations. And therefore, we allowed a few people into the building. Otherwise, you know, this church has got so many members. And most of them are joining us live. And most of them will be watching throughout the week. Give them a hand once again. Thank you for joining us. I just want to thank the leadership for going to extreme ends and detail upon detail to ensure that the safety of our members is not compromised. I really appreciate your leadership. Thank you so much. And let us continue to serve the people of God the way we're serving them. Amen. This morning, I'm sharing the word of God, and I just concluded a teaching earlier, a few hours ago, or literally an hour or so ago, and I'm continuing with the same teaching. And I'd like to say that I will literally continue and not start as I started. So if you're looking for a repeat or a full repeat of the sermon of the morning, you are on the wrong path. So those of you who did not have the privilege to listen into the teaching earlier on, I challenge you after church, go back and tune into your Facebook, tune into your YouTube, and catch up with the earlier sermon. So this sermon is a continuation. We continue where we ended. Is that okay? But however, I will do what we call a recap so that you are brought into the picture, but we are continuing. So if you are watching us in the morning, you have something new to learn this afternoon. You are in the right place, you're in the right space, and thank you for joining us in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say, I have power with my tongue. The topic says, you are the prophet of your own life. You are the prophet of your own life. You are the prophet of your own life. In other words, you do not need a prophet to tell you what your future looks like. You are that prophet. You can stand up in the middle of nowhere and begin to speak things into your future that will definitely come to pass. According to God, your future must not be a guesswork. Oh. According to God, your future must not be whether your future will come to pass or not. According to God, you should know what your future looks like. You should be so authoritative about your life to a point where you even tell what year and what age you will die at. Somebody said, this pastor is controversial. I'm not. You can stand on the word of God and speak with certainty into your future that I will die at 90 years. You can. You can speak into your future. Glory be to God. Of course, that sounds like a shock if you are not in faith. But those of us who are in faith, we understand what the word of God says about long life. What the word of God says about how long we should live. And therefore, we believe what the word of God says. We don't live our lives as those who don't know. We know what our future holds. And therefore, we are teaching you this morning that you are the prophet of your own life. You can stand and speak into your future, and your future will be shaped according to what you determine, according to what you say about your future. You don't need a prophet in a church to tell you what your future looks like. If a prophet speaks, he must speak to confirm that which you already know. Therefore, you don't go from church to church looking for what they say about you. You got to say your future. You don't wait for your future to happen to you. You happen to your future. You tell your future what your future must look like according to the word of God. Is somebody with me this morning?